Seriously, I've never thought this way about a Bleach character, but what a disgusting piece of shit. Look at this fucking picture. Look at him hiding like a fucking cowardice bitch, trying to shoot little shots of fucking love. Just look. It's disgusting. I don't know what kind of fucking character design Kubo went for, but that has got to be the most vilest fucking thing I've ever seen in my fucking life in a Bleach chapter. Like, what is that? Look, just, ugh, I just want to fucking punch it in the face. But I guess I got to get this Bleach chapter started, so let's go. Right, from what we know about this chapter is that Kintaro and Rosa, they're dead. They're pretty much fucking dead. I actually generally don't see them coming back to life. They're done. What Mayuri has done, though, he has swapped the blood within their body to make them so Mayuri can control them. By Juji putting in a smaller reactor of blood into them or onto them or whatever, it gets into their heart and from then on spreads around the whole body as normal fucking human biology. But Mayuri having each blood fucking container of each and every soldier in the Gotei 13 for scientific reasons, I guess, and by using the drug that he created allows the blood to be modified into a blood-like substance that he created himself, hence why he can take over the zombies that Juji made at this moment in time. But what makes me say that these guys are dead for sure? The fact that Byakuya said, why couldn't have you have just let them die? And Mayuri said, well, as a soldier of the Gotei 13, wouldn't you want to still be relevant and still be helping to the Gotei 13 for the security, even after death? So somewhat I agree that Kensei and Rose, even after death, would love to make not their death in vain, because that's the kind of characters that they are, and I do agree with that. But it's just a bit dark on how it's done. Obviously, you know, Mayuri is a sick bastard, but he has his reasons somewhat. They ain't justified, but I can kind of understand. But then, of course, after all that explanation, fucking you, I'm just looking at this fucking page. He's there behind a fucking rock with his shitty, crusty fucking diapers. Just there, like, you can see half of his fucking head. He's just there going, fucking, let's just get a shot in real quick. It looks so disgusting, like this fat fucking black midget just coming out of nowhere with... What the fuck was you thinking? Kubo, this has to be one of your worst fucking... I would take Charlotte over this disgusting fuck. I mean, fair play to Kubo getting me pissed off like this, but looking at his disgusting fucking face, just wanna throw a fucking brick. And thank you, Kensei, for literally punching that absolute fuck out of him. It's a bit pathetic, really, on how weak this dude is. He is weak as he fucking looks. He doesn't look strong in the fucking slightest. And for Kensei to just grab his face and throw him, it just goes to prove a lot of things. This dude is all fucking talk, all fucking just throw fucking hearts out there and use other people because he can't fight his own fucking battles. What did the Vol Standing do? Absolutely fuck all, because you're a weak piece of fucking shit. You're hiding behind buildings trying to snipe fucking people. Oh, this fucking character, man. Fuck this guy. If anyone likes him, fuck you. No, seriously, like, I would generally, if you generally like this character, fucking give me a good fucking reason, because this guy just pisses me off. And usually, if you had one bit of fucking sense, you'd realise that someone without a conscience can't experience fucking any emotion, let alone be fucking love. You retard. That's why your shitty move didn't fucking work. And when it comes to me fucking rooting for Lilate Lampart to fucking beat your ass down, then you know something's bad. Now, of course, we saw her at the end of the fucking chapter, like, giving him the cold fucking stare. And I know she's gluttony, but don't fucking eat the dude. You don't know what the fuck. You're gonna have extreme fucking diarrhea after that shit. So, I wouldn't, like, but it's bad when I'm rooting for a fucking Quincy to it's just so bad. Like, I'm rooting for the damn enemy. It just looks pathetic. But you know what, I'll give it a good I enjoyed this chapter rating, because that's my ratings apparently, because I don't give them numbers. But it's I really enjoyed this chapter, despite the fact that I hate this fucking dude. He got knocked the fuck out plenty of times and he got made to look like a piece of shit, so I like that. I like that this dude hopefully doesn't stay in the chapters for very long, because the sooner we get rid of him, the sooner the fucking better. Mayuri explained what he did to the zombies, which I found very informative and a big hint to whether these captains are alive or dead. I'm going to go with the theory that they're dead, they ain't coming back, that's it, vamoosh. So, I mean, it's weird because being as a war, you'd think, oh, well, there's not many captains dying. You know, Kubo's not killing off many characters. I mean, he's killed off quite a few captains, if you think about it. Probably not in the way that most people would expect captains to die, you know, through battle, through literally having their arm torn off or their head ripped off, but in a very different way of thinking about it. Like, Grammy just imagined that them two were dead. And it was so, I mean, I wouldn't say it was disappointing, it was just so like, oh, okay, so that happened, kind of thing. Like, I don't know, but I'm also glad that fucking Gigi died as well. Well, she ain't officially dead, but she got fucking stabbed by Kensei. So it's good that these characters, you know, are still putting up a fight. I mean, I am disappointed that they didn't go full out Bankai with Voizard fucking mode. But I don't know what can happen in future chapters of Bleach. I'm just really disappointed in the Voizards. I have so much potential, yet they're not using it. But let's be honest, as soon as Pepe and fucking Gigi's out of the way, hopefully we can get to Jubok versus Kurinji. That's if Kubo doesn't skip the fights. Well, we don't know. But tell me your thoughts in the comment section down below, guys. It's coming from last week. Please tell me what you honestly think of Pepe, and really just please, like, if there's one person, just, there's always that one person in the world that likes him. Just, what do? You just reevaluate yourself. And if you generally do, I want to hear a good fucking reason. Well, what do you think of my theory of the captains? Do you think they are dead? And do you think that by next chapter we'll hopefully see the end of Pepe and Gigi, and hopefully go back to seeing what's going on in the Soul Post with Jubok versus Kurinji? What do you think Kubo's going to skip the fights and have Jubok, like, just sitting on a throne of skulls? Is that, like, if Kubo generally wanted to stop the fights and just completely skip it, Jubok was sitting there on a throne full of fucking skull and bones of the whole Zero Division, I would find that hype regardless. I would be like, what the fuck happened? I'd be really fucking hyped, but I guess that's the only point where I'd let it slide, because the hype would just, like, overwhelm me and I wouldn't seem to care. Catch you motherfuckers later anyway, guys. You guys, of course, have been Hanson. Catch you guys next Bleach chapter, and peace out, you filthy, dirty, slutty motherfuckers. Take care.